Hello everyone, my name is Jin-Ah Park. I'm an associate professor of airway biology in the Department of Environmental Health at the Harvard T.H. Chan School of Public Health. I'm very excited to present our recently published work to you on behalf of my co-authors. I'm a co-corresponding author on this paper together with Dr. Joanne, Sordillo at Harvard Medical School and Harvard Pilgrim Healthcare Institute. Environmental exposure plays a critical role in the development of asthma, including triggering asthma exacerbations. During this exposure, airway epithelial cells are damaged and initiate a cascade of immune responses, leading to worsening asthma symptoms and exacerbations. Therefore, understanding how airway epithelial cells respond to environmental exposure is crucial for studying asthma pathogenesis. For this published work, we aim to identify unique transcriptomic profiles of human bronchial epithelial cells in response to lipopolysaccharide and house mite, because both are known to trigger asthma exacerbations. When cells are well differentiated in air liquid interface culture, we expose them to LPS, HDM, or a combination of both apically for 4 hours. We then perform the RNA sequencing analysis to identify differentially expressed genes, protein interaction network, and gene ontology. We then further validated the top-ranked differentially expressed genes. First, we analyzed differentially expressed genes across each treatment compared to the vehicle control in all 6 donors, regardless of their disease status. In panel A, the upset plot indicates the combined exposure to LPS and HDM result in the highest number of differentially expressed genes, followed by the individual exposure to LPS and HDM. In panels B to D, protein-protein interaction network for differential gene expression also indicate the combined exposure include the highest number of nodes, indicating the most complicated network. Next, we compare the differentially expressed genes induced by its exposure in the cells between donors with and without asthma, and then mapped these differentially expressed genes for protein-protein interactions. In all 3 exposure conditions, the cells from patients with asthma showed much more complex and highly connected protein networks. The volcano plot also indicates the number of differentially expressed genes is greater in response to each exposure in the cells from patients with asthma. While our studies do have some limitations, I'm very excited to share our key findings. Combined exposure to environmental asthma triggers result in greater transcriptomic responses, and the cells from patients with asthma exhibit increased sensitivity to these triggers. So we hope that the data from our studies can serve as a foundation for further research into mechanisms linking the exposome and asthma development. Thank you for your attention. I also want to thank our funding sources, including the NIHS Center Pilot Program, for supporting this study.